Sitagliptin is a dipeptidyl peptidase 4 or DPP4 inhibitor, a class of drugs used to treat type 2 diabetes. It does this by affecting special hormones called incretins, which your body releases from the gastrointestinal tract when you eat. Incretins help lower blood glucose levels. Imagine you are eating a burger. In response to ingested food, the intestines release the incretin hormone glucagon-like peptide 1, or GLP-1, which travels around the body and sends signals to various organs. In the pancreas, GLP-1 stimulates pancreatic islet beta cells to release insulin, the hormone that helps cells take up glucose from the bloodstream. GLP-1 also suppresses pancreatic islet alpha cells from releasing glucagon, thus preventing glycogen conversion to glucose. These actions reduce blood glucose levels. GLP-1 also affects the stomach by slowing gastric emptying. Food remains in the stomach longer, and this makes you feel full and satisfied for longer after a meal. Slow gastric emptying also means glucose from your food enters the bloodstream at a steady pace instead of a sharp spike. This helps stabilize blood glucose levels. Additionally, GLP-1 acts on the brain to make you feel satisfied with the meal eaten, thus decreasing appetite and making you eat less. But there is a catch. The helpful GLP-1 hormone is relatively short-lived. An enzyme called dipeptidyl peptidase 4 or DPP4 quickly breaks it down. Sitagliptin is a DPP4 inhibitor. By stopping DPP4 from doing its job, sitagliptin allows GLP-1 to stay in your bloodstream longer, and this prolongs the good things it does. As a result, sitagliptin helps your body do a better job of controlling high blood glucose. Sitagliptin is typically taken orally and can be used in combination with other anti-diabetic medications, including metformin or insulin. The most commonly reported side effects of sitagliptin include common cold symptoms, including stuffy or runny nose and sore throat, respiratory tract infections, and headaches. Sitagliptin may also cause rare but serious side effects such as pancreatitis and heart failure. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.